be our honor if we can get an idea from you about energy law and why we should know energy law.
Oh, that's wonderful. So your question is that why should we study energy law? Sir, आपने बता तो दिया कि law पढ़ना चाहिए, पर energy law क्यों पढ़ना चाहिए? Okay, all right. See, for all, मतलब it's a general question. What is the basic necessity of life? If this question is asked, भाई what is the basic necessity of life? So India में हमें क्या जवाब मिलता है? रोटी, कपड़ा, मकान. ये basic necessity है life की. तो generally जब discussion करते हैं तो this is what is told to everyone कि रोटी, कपड़ा, मकान basic necessity है. Food, water, health. That's wonderful. लेकिन let us assume Discovery Channel आप सब लोग देखते हैं, National Geographic Channel देखते हैं आप लोग सब. अगर किसी भी person को एक island पे छोड़ दिया जाए तो उस आइलैंड पे वो क्या चीज ढूंढेगा? जस्ट इमेजिन व्हाट ही सर्चेस फॉर. एंड यू हैव सीन इन टीवी, इतने सारे चैनल्स आ रहे हैं. सबसे पहले तो वो खाना ढूंढता है, फूड, रोटी, करेक्ट. लेकिन सेकेंड थिंग विच ही सर्चेस फॉर इज नॉट हाउस, नाइदर इट इज क्लोथ्स. ही सर्चेस फॉर एनर्जी, फायर. बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली इट इज जो बेसिक नेसेसिटी की डेफिनेशन है उसमें मिसिंग है हमारे, हम रोटी, कपड़ा, मकान भी से. बट देन इफ आई से ठीक है, एक बंदे को आइलैंड पे छोड़ दिया जाए एंड ही स्टार्ट, यू नो, स्टार्ट्स अ न्यू लाइफ. First thing he will look for food, but the second thing which he will look for is energy, fire. So effectively, what I believe, Shraddha, jo basic necessity of life is fourfold. First is roti, second is urja, and then kapra makan. So second most important basic necessity of life is energy. So if it is basic necessity of life, then let us know what are the laws governing energy sector in India. Number one. Number two, as I discussed earlier, ki the golden thread of law protects, you know, before birth and after death. Similarly, whenever an energy company commences its business, before commencement of the business, before incorporation of the business, lot of legal compliances have to be done. If an energy company who wishes to do trading of electricity does not have a trading license, it cannot commence trading of electricity. If a company which wants to do transmission of electricity, if he does not have a transmission license, he cannot commence transmission of electricity. It is not allowed. It is illegal. So before the power business starts, you have to incorporate a company, you have to prepare memorandum of association, article of association, you have to be clear as to what are the goals of the company, you have to do all the compliances. So for example, hydro company aapko start karni hai, so there are 20 compliances of central government which are mandatory. There are 10 to 11 compliances of state government, depending on which state you are starting a hydro power project. So effectively 30 to 32 compliances karne ke baad hi hydro power plant start ho sakta hai, it cannot start before that. So before the birth of a hydro power, it is for all the kabhi compliances kam hote hain, kabhi compliances jyada hote hain, but it is only a matter of which sector you are working in. Okay, so before the energy company is born, there are legal compliances which has to be done, and golden thread of law works there also. And after the company dies, so if for example the company is not doing well financially, it will go into insolvency and bankruptcy court, it will go into liquidation. So after the company stops transmission business or discontinues solar business or discontinues any energy business, there are compliances which have to be made under insolvency and bankruptcy court and under companies act, under various other laws actually. Okay, so agar company, power company start karne se pehle, you have to do lot of compliances. Jaise I gave example of hydro sector, jahan pe 20 compliances by central government, legal compliances, and 10 legal compliances by state government on an average. Similarly, if a company is dissolved or discontinues working in power sector, there are compliances of winding up or insolvency or liquidation. And if we are working in the power sector, and I know a lot of you are from PSUs, you have served the PSU for next last 10 to, you know, 1 to 2 decades, and for next 1 to 2 decades you will be serving the energy sector. Let us understand the energy sector, how it works. Third aspect is that the brain of the power sector is electricity laws, electricity act 2003, and whatever brain commands we all work accordingly actually. So if we understand the brain, it is easier for us to move forward in life.